Alright, hello. I am going to be making a pumpkin real quick in 3DSMax from scratch. So what I do is I go to the primitives and I grab a sphere. I like 21 segments, that works pretty well. We're just going to go ahead and make our sphere here. That's good. And I'll go ahead and convert it to a poly. From here I'll go select, hold control to select multiple at a time, and every two I am selecting two edges. Here, hold up, I think I accidentally clicked on someone that aren't there. So every two, so every two loops here I'm grabbing two edges, so like that and that, all the way around. And then go up here in the modeling tab and click loop, and that should grab all the edges like that for you. And then I go into the scale, and instead of clicking in the middle here, I click in this bottom one to only scale these two axes, and I scale it down just a little bit, and that gives you that divots in the pumpkin kind of look. And then I go ahead, go to the polygons. So this just looks like a ball right now. But if we go here and I turn on soft selection, fill out 20, we'll see how that is. I don't know, I think I want a little bit more than that. Yeah, so let's bring this into the larger view here. That looks a bit more natural, I would say. And you could even scale it up a little bit, you know, mess with it, just try to get it right. I'm thinking move it up a little bit there, and then also on the top I would go ahead and make sure you select all the polys there if you're in perspective view, and just kind of scale it down on the z-axis a little bit there too, maybe pull it down a bit like that. Everything's looking pretty good so far. We've got a pumpkin here. Let's go ahead and... it doesn't really matter that much. This is our pumpkin shape, I think. Let's make it orange for now, just to remind us what it's supposed to be. So, pumpkin. And I'll go ahead and put a stem on it as well. So if we come up here to the top, I'm not sure if this will work fine. Ring maybe? No. Okay. So you can go like this, select all of these triangles up here, and I inset right about, you know, I mean, whatever works best for you, but I like to do it when the vertices get pretty close like that, so I can just go through and, let's go hide this soft and selection for now, and I'm going to hide the unselected. That'll help me just get and work with these, and also turning off soft selection helps you see what you're doing. So there we go. And then I just like to collapse these, it makes it pretty simple to, and that's going to help reduce the poly count on this pumpkin as well. So now that you have that, I'm going to go ahead and just go back to a polygon selecting and unselect all. Oh, well, actually I want that there. And what I'll do here is bevel. So you can bevel out a stem like that. And then, you know, if you want it lower, do what you want there. I think that's a pretty good stem for now. Oh wait, actually, hold up. Before we make the stem, let's go ahead and make this a jack-o'-lantern. Pressing F, that'll bring you into the front view. Now, I could just say here's my face and delete these, but let's do something More interesting. So if I go to quick slice? No. Freeform. So maybe I want to draw on surface, pick the surface, and then I think, oh, no, that's not quite right. No, stay with me here. Oh, I'm making a bunch of weird stuff. All right. I think it might just be in here somewhere where you can do a drawing selection. Looks like paint connect. That might be it. Let's do a different face. So if this is the middle, let's give him some angry eyes. I'll teach how to fix that later, maybe. And then how about a bit of a evil smile here, if that works out all right, huh? Then I'll go ahead and, oh, still have this on, my bad. So these can be collapsed here, this part, those are joining, let's collapse those, collapse these. And we've got kind of like a face in our pumpkin here. And you can just delete the polygons to fit the face of your pumpkin or jack-o'-lantern, I suppose. So you can see that. And then I just go ahead, select the whole thing, hold shift, and scale it down however deep you want your jack-o'-lantern to go. And then make sure you select two element. And then you have this selected, click flip, and that flips the normal so that now the inside is that way. I'll turn it to shaded so we can see still in there. And then if you come to your edge, you can use the bridge tool to bridge gaps like those. And you know, you just go through and do that till that's all made well. It's turned to clay so you can see that tends to help. Oh. Oh, hold up. Am I not bridging these? Huh. Weird. So I don't know what was up with that. Oh, it looks like we forgot some polygons here. Oh. So delete those. And those. Looks fine to me. But now we can go ahead and make the stump like before. And, you know, just bevel. Oh, that looks pretty good to me. Maybe. I can always go change some things if I want, like this. And that's kind of a jack-o'-lantern there. You know, you might want to give it a flat bottom like that. You know, whatever works best for you. Maybe you want the inside to be flat. You can change that in there. You know, work with it. And, oh, one last thing. Let's go ahead and give it a UV map. So, let's unwrap the UVs here, and I have a texture here ready for it. It's just a seamless like pumpkin texture. It should be on now. So let's open up the UV editor. Yep, there it is. If I just click the polygons here, And oh, over here, select the sphere. That should do good for it. And then resize it however I need. I can't see it right now. I need to change it to realistic. So resize it to fit. Maybe if you want to try and shove the grooves where they actually go, you know, do that. And then usually, you know, to save on size again, I'll go ahead and convert this back to a poly. If you want to go ahead and enable the vertex channel display, you can kind of just make this a decent looking stem with just brown vertex coloring like that. And there you have a nice little jack-o'-lantern for whatever you need.